Oh, hi.
Nicely done! Give him a round of applause.
Oh, wow.
All right.
No touching.
Sorry about that. Better day. Guys, can I have everybody take a seat, please? That way everyone can see.
What's up?
Yeah, they'll eat the fish. Ah, so. If you guys want to take a seat so they can see in the back there. You can actually see behind you. You can see? Okay. All right, here we go. So, there's that fish in there, yes. That is a halibut, or was a halibut.
Look like catfish.
It looks like catfish? Mm. Yeah, well, it's hard to identify fish when they're that dead already. But yeah. Basically, we'll find fish from around town. People are out catching fish, and they'll fillet them, so they're keeping that halibut for themselves. Then you put the fish carcass in there, and the crabs smell that. Mm. So then they come in through that opening there, and it falls back down on them. They can't get back out.
Yeah.
If they're small, they can, though. So, does anyone know how big a crab has to be to keep them?
6 inches tall.
Close, that, and that's true in Washington State or Oregon. So, here, they have to be 6.5 inches. They gotta be a little bit bigger. So, they can escape through these rings on either side if they're smaller than that. We don't want to keep the small ones anyways. And then, the pot is held closed by that piece of string right here. This is called rotten cotton, and we are required to use this. So that's because this is going to dissolve after a couple weeks. So what happens out here, you got a lot of boats. Someone might run over your pot and you lose it at the bottom of the ocean. So then you got all these pots down there collecting crabs. You don't want that. So that's going to dissolve. That flips open and the crabs can go free. Oh, little baby guy. So I'm going to show you guys how to identify a male and a female.
Yeah.
Careful. Anyone know already?
The belly.
The belly, yeah. You got it. So, I'll spin around so you guys can all see. But when you're identifying crabs, you flip them over. Yeah, doing a little dance for you. The females have a round, like, dome shape on the bottom. Like that. And female. The male has a longer, narrow shape on his apron. So, we say it looks like the Washington Monument and the Capitol Building dome. So, I'll spin around so you guys can get pictures side by side.
Male or female?
We do. We can't eat the females.
Oh, okay.
Cannot eat the females.
Never.
One of the pinchers.
He did, he lost a pincher, so he can grow that back.
Oh, grow back.
Yeah, it will grow back. So you measure measure from notch to notch rather than point to point. So this one is too small. This one's 6 inches, so another half inch.
Oh,
to go.
Wow.
What's the fine for bringing it under
J-Do.
I don't know the exact, what's the exact fine? $250 per crab, he said, if you get one that's smaller.
Do they check it under the port?
Smoking. And they pinch really painfully,
do,
right?
Yes, yes,
take them to get full size in time.
It takes you about 5 or 6 minutes to get them to full size. Yeah, they'll move, they can move up to...
You can feel it breathing?
Yeah, if you let her kill you.
Even if they're big enough, they won't
How long can they stay out of water?
For 12 hours.
Yeah.
Sorry, dude. I didn't
even
drop you.
Well, yeah, you smart,
like,
careful,
you might
pinch. Yeah. 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 Yeah, he's gonna go back in the water anyway. Too small.
What? Hey, Fred. You named him Fred.
Why not?
Missing
because it's brackish water. Brackish water is going to create, there's a lot of mud in this area. So this is where they're coming to breed. And then they'll
Anyone?
Bury themselves
Any adventurous
in that mud
soul?
To get there. So that's why they like it here. They would be feeding on, they're scavengers. So any kind of dead fish on the bottom, they'll go after clams and mostly bottom feeders.
In you go.
When you put these back, you have to take them out of the trap.
Yeah, so when we put them back in, we could throw a couple back individually, and then I've got two more tours today, so we'll keep a few.
That's a book one, yeah.
Yeah, one in your pocket. Yeah, you could set him down there for now. So we gotta count them. So that's what we do. We count them and let Fish and Game know how many we have. So
oh, wow.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. 21, 22.
You're my favorite.
Which one?
This one right here.
Oh, yeah. He's like, that's
so funny. So they keep an inventory of
cows. Yeah, just in this area, that's kind of how this tour kind of started. There was an invasive species of crab in here. And so they had these guys removing them. So we came out, or I wasn't here then, that was like 10 years ago. But they would remove that crab and count how many dungeness they had. Now there are no more of those invasive species. So they were able to remove them all. Green crab. And green crab, yeah. They are showing up again in the state of Washington. So it's being closely monitored. Because basically they'll take away the food source of the guys that are supposed to be here.
Can you eat them, the green?
Somewhere in Asia, so someone brought them over and released them. Mm-hmm.
Can we eat those green crabs?
No, people don't eat them. I guess they are also more prone to, like, disease. So they, the Dungeness crab can get diseases.
Oh,
from
I see.
Too.
One is upside down.
Then we have this zinc there, so that's sacrificial metal. So the salt water is going to erode that before it
instead
erodes the stainless steel. Yeah. So this is typical of what a local is going to be using.
Okay. And this will deteriorate over time.
Yeah.
Which was, and then the little
iron cotton.
Easy for them if they get
exactly.
That's
yeah.
One idea.
Yeah.
Cheap way to do it. You know?
Exactly, and like right now in the state of Washington or other places, there are a lot of lost traps down there, and so they have to like scuba divers going down trying to get rid of these traps in the ocean.
Nó có nhiều những cái bãi này ở bên bang Washington đó, người ta cứ để đó vậy bao nhiêu con cá nuôi vào nó chết như vậy người ta phải nhặt nó ra. Bởi vì bao nhiêu con cứ đi vào đây mà xong nó không ra được, nó chết, đói nó chết. Người ta phải bỏ nó ra.
So if it gets you, there's a couple things you can do. Well, first of all, your reaction is going to be to go, ah, the crab's pinching me. But then here's what happens. The crab's like, ah, you're swinging me in the air. He's not going to let go, right? So the first thing you need to do is set him down on a hard surface. And chances are he'll let go. But if he doesn't and it's really that hard, you can rip off his leg and it'll grow back. So. But at that point, yeah.
Take it home and eat it.
Yeah, take it home and eat it. That's how, like, stone crabs. In certain places, you can harvest just the one leg and just throw them back because they can grow them back. And they can. Oh, you got an eagle on here? Oh, yeah, two of them sitting up on the tree together.
Oh, go, chim, go, chim. Bỏ eagle. Go, chim, ở trên tổ.
These crabs are pretty loud when you leave them out of the water. They can keep breathing for 12 hours and you can hear it. You want to listen?
Yeah. Oh yeah. Yeah, it sounds like a mouse, a mice eating.
Oh.
again?
Yeah.
That's okay.
Wait, hold on.
Yeah.
Thank you. Get your dog. Your uncle can catch his bigger crab.
Yeah.
Ketchikan, Alaska. Ngày 11 tháng 9, 2017. Thứ hai. Cảm bé nha, cảm bé. Bố đi được không? Okay. Đến cho bố tự do, bố không thích ai đụng. tell me more about this Buckeye chocolate.
Yeah, so it's this little round, you know what a Buckeye looks like the nut?
Not really. Nut.
Okay, so it's like round, and it's dark brown, so you got the milk chocolate, and then in the center, it's got peanut butter. So it's like a peanut butter cup, kind of, but they're more like homemade, like at the local chocolate shops in Ohio, you can find them.
Okay.
Yeah, they're so good.
I will look on it online, and maybe
you
on
should,
a special order one.
Yeah.
Can I close this?
In a minute, yeah. If you want to grab it. Sure.
Yeah, especially all the fruits and nuts.
Yeah.
talk about them.
Finally, his wife's like, all right, enough's enough. Let's go get a real house now.
Now there comes that waterfall that you saw earlier, so you'll get another chance for a good picture. Did anyone take the shuttle over to the Alaskan Brewing Company in Juneau? No? You guys got to try any of their beers? We have one of their beers at our lodge, and your first drink's on the house, so you'll get to try it if you want. We got the Amber beer. But the Alaskan Brewing Company comes out here, they collect spruce tips from our Sitka spruce out here, and they brew beer out of it. It's pretty good. So spruce tip beer, look for that. Basically, like, instead of using hops, you'll use spruce tips. Here comes that log cabin I told you about. So, up ahead of us, on the left front window, you'll see a boat on the shore. So as we pass by that, you'll be able to see the log cabin.